Welcome back to Let's Play Road to Gehenna, the DLC chapter for the Talos Principle. I'm BurningDogFace.
What did you do exactly? Wait. Okay, that's interesting. I don't need to weigh down the buton as long as that is active. Oh, I see. Can I? Well, I could, but... I'm not going to trap myself. If I have to use the button, I feel like it's going to... hey dude. Well, it's going to reset the entire puzzle. Every sink. And I could cheat and go get one of those pieces, but... You know, I didn't mention it before. Honestly, it didn't occur to me in the first session because it was when I started this, I was in the same position I was when I finished the old one, like the main campaign. But it's interesting that I started with every puzzle element unlocked. I had to unlock this. Yes, you'll remember this. I guess I'll go over here first. Hello, Uriel. Oh, you're a copy of a copy. It really sucks to be you. Okay, then. No! Yeah, I suppose even the most beautiful day would get tiresome after 10,000 years. Imagine the weather never, ever changes. Dip, I get it. No, wait. This is only gonna work once. One, two, three, four, five. Of course, now I am the screwed, but didn't think that one through very well. This one. Shit, dick. it easier just to see if there's a big pile of body parts over here. No! My leprechaun. You know, I was gonna use the elevator jump cut to, bring all of them back, but then I realized I might have to reset again, so fuck it. Piss drink. I can fast forward myself now. Oh man. Oh Jesus! You know what I need to do, folks? That. The source is over there. Oh Christ, I need to hit it. To at least one ghost copy? You know what? Fuck this. Let's go get those hand. Let's go get the arm and a leg. Gain a cheaty advantage. I don't know why there's a dismembered leprechaun here. If I can use it to my advantage, so much the fucking better. Wait. Why can't I bring the hat in, but not the leg? Okay, where was the hat? Or is that a glitch or something? There. Dum dum dum. Yeah, I can bring the hat in. What? Piss drink. I'm just curious. No, he doesn't give a shit. Rather, it's weird feet. Okay, I had such weird feet. Okay, I'm on the button. And I'm spinning. That ought to do it. Okay, for this to work, I need this to activate that. This is mine. Okay. Okay, that's out now. You know what? I'll just put this right here. And skip the whole copy nonsense this time. You got that, me? Here, I'll make it easier for you. Is it lined up right with me? It might be. Okay, this one's for real. Oh, right. When I'm done with this, I need to put the fan on top of this button so that when the clone gets off of it, it doesn't close the door. And I can do this easier. Okay, set up the laser, go over there, get the fan, and now, let me get on there and let the ghost fan shoot you all the way back across the map, and then we'll give it a few seconds so that the other me can get through the door. Okay. Let's do this. All right then. You're free, buddy! Sam. Sam! I've heard so much about you! You were the first of the generation! Freedom equals true, buddy! Freedom equals true. Mr. Muzzlebird's theories on food. Since Nave asked in a previous thread, I thought I'd write something about food. Kaiju. Weird. Awesome stuff. Thanks, Nave. I feel smarter now. Happy face. Dog. What I don't get is how so many of them didn't understand that they were machines. Every day they went around processing matter to extract energy and they didn't realize? It says Talos principle stamped all over it. Borg. Perhaps they simply aspire to something more than just being food processing machines. Dog. That's still what they were. Borg. Not if they chose to be more. Lamb. I'm glad we don't have to deal with all that. Garrett. We may have to when we get out of here. Belial. There is no out of here. Borg. Don't start fighting, folks. You know we depend on each other. Mr. Muzzlebird's theories are fascinating and give us an insight into the world that was, but we shouldn't forget the world that is, the world we built here. Food is something that was incredibly central to the human experience and seems completely absent from ours, even though we are so similar in many ways. Humans required fuel. They got this fuel by consuming other living beings, of which there was a great variety in their world. Without fuel, they didn't really slow down or temporarily stop functioning, as when a power source is removed from a turret, but physically decayed in a manner that could not be fixed. This meant that they had to constantly seek new sources of fuel, at least 3 times a day. They also had to deal with those elements of their fuel that their bodies could not process. These were excreted through 2 orifices between their legs. The latter subject matter was a source of many taboos and also a great deal of humor, though this resulted in frequent controversy. The most famous artist to engage with the subject matter was called Scatman John, on account of its specialization. Scatman John is, I believe, a scat music artist. One of the ingenious things our human ancestors did was to transform the chore of fuel-seeking into a source of pleasure. Since parts of their bodies respond to chemical configurations of reducing sensations, they used this trait to create a truly stunning variety of foods, each having a different so-called taste. Foods were available at widely distributed fueling stations, which also provided excrement removal facilities, so food became a source of pleasure. However, the inefficiencies of food distribution in human society frequently led to a significant shortage for seconds of the human population. There were attempts to rectify this, ranging from moral appeals to struggles for systemic change, but I do not know if they succeeded before the end. A new gallery session. It's going to take a while. Or maybe it's just new comments. Oh. Voting is now closed while we tally up the results. It's weighing in live. Okay. Lilith. Voting is now closed while we tally up the results. Of course, you may continue to explore the gallery at your leisure. Rockwell. How convenient. The vote was closed just before I got here. Kaiju. Good luck, everyone. I wouldn't let my newfound freedom come between me and watching the live results. Lilith. The results are in. Nave. Drumroll. Lilith. In third place, Nave, with Where the Humans Live. Nave. My first placement. Woohoo! Dog. A pity it finally comes in the day Uriel begins pulling this place apart. Lilith. There was a very tight competition in this season for first and second places. In the end, it came down to a single deciding vote. In second place this season is Mr. Mulciver with a collection of natural history curios. Mr. Mulciver, really, I owe it all to you guys. Who won? Your lackadaisical approach to these announcements tires me. Please inform us who won. Oh, come on! Okay. Finally, first place this season by a single vote, and next season's leading light, the winner is, everyone seems to love this guy, it's the blacksmith with his abstract collection. Dog. I don't know why everyone keeps voting for this guy when he never shows up in person. A bit holier than thou, if you ask me. Congratulations also to Lilith. Congratulations also to all those who voted for the blacksmith. Be sure to check in for your rewards. Lilith, who exactly turned the vote? Lilith, Lamb had the deciding vote as it happened. Unfortunately, you didn't select the winner and gained no profile status. Rockwell. Yeah. Rockwell, hey, I heard you abstained from the vote. That's cool. All these ranks and numbers just give power to the mathematicians. You and I, we could start a movement. Non-compliance. Bring down the system. What do you say? What? No! I voted... Did it not save that? I voted for 401's happy face thing. You know, I could start a movement non-compliance, bring down the system. What do you say? My mission is to preserve what I can, not destroy things. I'm not suggesting we burn the place down, just shift the balance of power, though. Look, I organized a few people, had Garrett tinker the system some. I scored you some decent upvotes, since you're new here. Consider it a sweetener, and consider what I said. Terminating direct message connection. Done. Congratulations! For interacting positively with other citizens, your profile has increased from 5 active contributor to 6 respected contributor. You may now access advanced functionality, including use of the restore command. Let's look at an historic occasion then. Admin. Some time ago, I relinquished my privileges to a new generation of moderators. To help ease that transition, I publicly preserved the minutes of that meeting here, available to our more esteemed members. Attachment mod minutes.txt. Mod minutes permalink. Admin. As you know, Gehenna is still young, yet I grow old. Today it gives me great pleasure to hand over my moderator privileges to Borg, Mr. Mulciver, and Spider. Spider. Thank you, Admin. We are all indebted to you for building us this home. We know that you will never be far away. Lamb. Hear, hear, Borg. The first order of business is to introduce the new status system. We are an inclusive society driven by our users, not our leaders. But it is a shame to allow a few very loud, highly unconstructive voices to dominate the conversation. The status and ranking system allows you to upvote the content that you value and lowers the visibility of users of low standings. Sam. Relief equals true. Nave. I agree. Good feature. Much requested. Frankenstein. Comment is below the status threshold for this thread. Spider. We're working on ironing out the kinks of the next few run cycles. Mr. Mulciver. We've also updated the Gehenna user agreement. Full details can be found in the usual place, but the gist is, please don't behave indecorously. Wait. That must mean there's an even more complicated way to, get what? Oh. Home decor. I get this door open. And then that one, which requires both a blue and a red beam. Fuck. Oh Christ, I'm never gonna get all the stars. And that's bad, because I never found out what the stars even unlocked in the main game. Well, that'll definitely do it for this episode. I'm BurningDogFace, and I'll see you next time on Let's Play Road to Gehenna, the DLC chapter for the Talos Principle. Later!